So very good morning everyone. So in previous class we discussed some of the topics. So one is IOP beam prong for emails compromise. Okay, ghost, similarly for ghost project dot fr, also used for the whether emails have been compromised or breached, you can say. And we also discuss one of the concepts like web forensics. In that one is a site : website name. Okay, and one is a in URL. Okay, and any specific word, it may be hacking. We'll show you all the words which contains in its URL. It shows all the pages. If you type any word, example hacking in its URL. So I discuss what is a URL. URL means a subdomain. It may be a domain name. It may be a folder name. And page extension also, you can say page name, parameter name, parameter values. All these seven comes under the URL here. Okay. So second dark we'll discuss today. Dark means nothing but a search. So in title : hacking. So in title hacking, it shows all the pages which contains the word hacking in its title. If you know HTML, you can know the title tag. All the pages in having will be listed here by the Google in title : hacking here. Okay, so this number of in title hacking, this number of results you can see. So another one, if you want to list from the specific domain, example, you can take the site : microsoft.com. Wait for a minute. If you want to list some specific domain, okay, then you can also put you can also use the site : microsoft.com. Can you give any website name here for specific? This hacking word can be used in the particular websites here. Here you can find the pages which contain the word called as a hacking in the specific domain called as a Microsoft. So another third dark in the title, you can say. Okay. Next, fourth dark. So you can use a calculator. Just type in Google cost 99. So you can see the scientific calculator here. So for Google, just type this is a calculator, scientific calculator. Sometimes you may get capture to protect your data from brute force attack. for this purpose we are using the CAPTCHA here. So you can use this Google scientific calculator. So another one we'll discuss. If I want to search the names of particular person, so I want to search my name in Google. Yes, so you can get the example. You can type my name in the Google. It shows all the pages that contains Vikram Narayan Das. Okay, but if you place some double quotes, so all related, you can search for Vikram as well as the Narayan Das separately if you type without double quotes. Okay, if I want to search only the Vikram Narayan Das, so I can keep some double quotes here, it's starting and ending point and search. So it lists exact face where we can find the words will be displayed here. Generally, some students, what will do, if you give any assignment, they will copy from Wikipedia or other sites and paste it. If you just double quote, there are the three or four words in a documentation in order to figure out where they were copied. Okay, so with the help of this double quotes, we can find where he's copied. Okay, so another doc, you can say doc is nothing but search. Next, we'll go for DHDB. Nothing but a Google hacking database, GHDB. So in that, go for Google exploit db.com. Click on this. You can see here, you can find n number of such types of docs, which gives the useful information here. So click on filters. So you can see some categories here. Click on the files, you can see some categories, any files, files containing usernames, sensitive directories, web servers, detection, vulnerability files, vulnerability servers, error messages, okay. And files contain some juicy information, files contain some passwords. Click on this, you can see n number of files, files containing the passwords, MySQL database password, okay. So you can observe here, few minutes back, we have discussed few things, how to notice file types here. Okay, different file types. It may be a CNV database password. You can see the file here. So if you want to list the SQL browsers here, sometimes SQL browsers. So file type, colon, SQL. So by this, we will show these number of SQL backups, you can say. These number of SQL backups. So it's a fantastic but dark, you can see. Dark means such again. It's a fantastic dark for SQL backups. So I want to also type the passwords of the SQL database. So file type colon SQL password. Click on that. You can see the so many more than 46,900 results backups, which contain the word password here. Okay. So click on this. You can notice some Oracle values here. Google will help how to find the list of information here. You can click, I can notice some usernames here, usernames, and password is in hash value. The password is in hash value. So this is a username, BRO admin, and password is in a hash value. It is encrypted here. So BRO is admin account of third party product here. You can notice here some usernames and passwords which are hashed. So if you decrypt, you can get the password here. So you know, one of the fantastic dark, you can say, is also to get the password of the admin as well as the passwords here. So what is the file type? File type colon SQL. File type colon SQL here. SQL password. Now I'll go with another search engine, same as a Google, Shodan. io. Shodan.io. So very handy for you for investigations. Not only for web, it also searches for not only for the web, it also searches for specific information. So you can create a login for this and explore whatever you want. Okay, if I want to search some CCTV, where I'm using the CCTVs. CCTV cameras. So how many people are using this type of CCTV cameras and versions, you can see. What are the IP addresses? Okay. What are the passwords they are using for that? Okay, what is the IP addresses? And which countries? Like that, you can see the information of the CCTV cameras. And you can also find specific version of web servers here. Example, you can use the Apache. Let me check some servers using Apache here. Just type Apache. So it will show how many servers are using Apache, which are in sites, which are using these sites. Okay. And Apache, which are using the file index. Okay, every search engine will use the index here for searching the information. We get the data from only from the indexes here. So how many people are using the Apache service? You can explore here. So you can also find some versions of specific Apaches here. It may be a Linux version, it may be a version 2.05. So one of the juicy information can we get from this Shodan.io. You can use same as a Google, the best search engine. So now we'll go for another one. Search engines. CNSYS.io. So another type of search engine here. So it's a paid one. If you want to do some commercial activities, you can check this in the site. Okay. One more. Zoomii.org is another type of kind of search engine, you can say. Example, type Apache. If you want to list the servers which are using in Zoomii Apache, you can see the versions here. You can also find the vulnerabilities. Click on vulnerabilities. You can see PHP my admin, how many vulnerabilities in the year, year wise you can see, and country wise also you can see here. Okay. So you will get some list of, you can find based upon the vulnerabilities also here. So recently some specific vulnerabilities came into identify in the network IP protocol. So that you can find list how many people are using these specific things here. So many long back, you can one more vulnerability called as a Heartbleed. Heartbleed. So many vulnerabilities you can see long back. If you want a list of how many servers are still using the same configurations of OpenSSL, SSL, you can find out in this site here. Okay. So I think so many students have not came. Tomorrow I'll discuss the remaining docs. Okay. I'll end with this simple docs today. This the simple file search engines here. So now I'll go for the syllabus again. So yesterday we discussed what is a SDLC and secure SDLC. Okay. Now we'll discuss the security professionals and organizations in the organizations. So we can see wide range of professionals to support diverse information security program. Yes. So they to develop some specific security policies and procedures here. So additional, we have one more administrative support, and also we need some technical expertise is required to implement the information security program. Okay. So we'll go one by one. One is a senior management. This senior management generally is a senior technology officer, you can say. Typically referred as a CIO, Chief Information Officer here. So other titles we can also give for him, like Vice President of Information Technology. Vice President of Information Technology or Vice President of Information and Vice President of Systems. So please remember these terminologies. Compulsory, if you go for any organization, if you work in companies, you can see these members here, Senior Technology Officer like CIO, VP, Vice President of Information Technology, Vice President of Information, Vice President of Systems, for are used generally. So primary responsible for advertising, advising this Chief Executive Officer and company owner, translate some specific strategy plans to the organization. This Chief Information Security Officer or Chief Information Officer generally responsible for advising the Chief Executive Officers and company owners for, and also translate some strategic plans to the organization. So another person can also see in senior management, one is the Chief Information Officer, another one is the Chief Information Security Officer. So one of the primary responsibility for this CISO is for assessment. One is for assessment. One is the management and the implementation part of the information security in the organization. So is also referred as manager for IT security and security administrator. Yes. As a primary responsible for assessment, management, and implementation of information security in the organization. Also referred as a manager for IT security and also security administrator. So generally reports directly to the CIO, Chief Information Officer, whatever it may be. Okay. So next one is the information security project team. So number of individuals who experienced in multiple requirements of both technical and non-technical. Both technical and non-technical here. You can call as a, you can see the different people you can see here. One is a champion. So who is a champion? It's a senior executive, you can say. Senior executive. Senior executive who promotes the project. A senior executive who promotes the project and ensures his support, both financially as well as administratively. Next one, you can see some team leaders in a company, in an organization. A team leader is generally called as a project manager. Yes, maybe a departmental line manager or a staff unit manager, you can also call him as a. So project manager may be a departmental line manager or a staff unit manager who understands project management, personal management, information security, technical requirements. It's nothing but a team leader. You can also have some security policy developers. So these are individuals who understand organizational cultures, some policies, some requirements, for developing and implementing some successful policies here. For implementing successful policies. Yes. Security policy developers are individuals who understand organizational culture, policies, requirements for developing and implementing successful policies. Next one is a risk assessment specialist. So these are individuals who understand financial risk. Financial risk, you can say. Financial risk assessments. Financial risk assessments. Techniques. And also value of organizational assets. Organizational assets. And security methods. So individuals who understand financial risk assessment techniques and organizational assets, value of organizational assets, security methods here. So we also have the security professionals. These are nothing but dedicated, trained, well-educated specialist in all aspects of information security. These are from both technical as well as non-technical standards. Okay, security professions. And security administrators. So these are responsibility for administrating the systems. Administrating the system. You can understand by the word keyword called as administrators. Administrating the systems. So we are talking about the systems here. That house information used by the organizations here. So next one is the end users. So users from various departments. So you can say levels and degrees of technical knowledge. So these end users assist the team for focusing on applications of some controls. What are the realistic controls you apply for on a particular asset, you can say. So you understand what is the information security project team, who are the members, one is champion, team leader, security policy developers, risk assessment specialist, security professionals, security system administrators, and as well as the individuals here. So one of the next one is the data responsibilities. In data responsibilities, we can have the data owners who is responsible for security and use of particular set of informations. So usually this data owners determines the level of data classification, you can see. Data classification. If you take your college, data classification associated data, as well as any changes required by the organizations. So we had data owner is responsible for data classifications. So you can maintain the information of regarding the various students, you can say, if it is your college. Okay, if it is organization, it maintains the level of data classification which is associated with the data, as well as any changes required by the organization. Next one is the data custodian, mainly responsible for storage, maintenance, and protection of your data, protection of your information, you can say. So which can include some data storage, backups, you can also maintain some backups. Data custody is nothing but you can maintain some data storage, backups, and overseeing, looking after your information, implement some specific procedures and policies. It's nothing but a data custodiancy. Next one is a data users. So data users is nothing but end users, end systems, you can say, work with the information to perform daily jobs, supporting mission of your organization, mission of your organization. Yes, included as a individuals with information security role, data users. These are end users, you can say, or end systems, work with information to perform daily job, supporting mission of your organization. Included as a individuals with information security role. So last one, communities of interest. So each organization develops and maintains its own unique culture and values. Unique culture and values. So there's some committees. One is information security management and professionals. First one, information security management and professionals. Information technology management and professionals, organizational management and professionals. So these are group of each organization develops and maintains its own unique culture and values here, and maintains some committees of interest. One is the information security management and professionals, information technology management and professionals, organizational management and professionals. So these are responsible to develop and maintain the cultures and policies and some values for the organization. So information security is an art or a science? Anyone? It's a combination of both art and science. So security is an art, as an art. So no art, no and fast rules, nor many universally accepted complete solutions to take the security as a heart. No manual for implementing security through entire system. Security is a science. So dealing with technology, if you take the technology designed to operate the higher levels of performance. So we need some specific conditions that cause virtually all actions that occur in the computer systems. Nearly every fault, security hole, system malfunctions are a result of interaction of specific hardware and software. Yes, it develops, if developers had sufficient time, they could resolve and eliminate the faults. So every organization maintains some security controls to avoid this faults here. Maintain some technologies to operate the higher levels of performance. Security as a social science. So social science examines the behavior of individuals interacting with the systems. So sometimes you are pretending as a if you're not pretending as a authorized persons, misbehave. Social science examines the behavior of individuals interacting with the systems. Typing the wrong passwords is a social science. Security begins and ends with the people that interact with the system. So what are the passwords you're using? Never save anywhere on the system. And don't reveal to any person. Security administrators can generally greatly reduce the levels of risk caused by the end users. We need a system of security administrators for every organization, for the supportable security profiles. So information security is a well-informed sense of assurance that information risk and controls in a balance. So what are the risks you are having in the organization and you want to maintain the controls? What are the firewalls you are using? What are the IDS you are using to protect your information in the organization? So you know that the history of the how the computer networks are developed, computer security has begun. So computer security has begun immediately after the first mainframes are developed. So many successful organizations have multiple layers of security in their place. It may be a physical security, it may be a personal security, it may be operational security, it may be a communication security, it may be network security, information security. All these concepts we covered in the previous class. So security should be considered in a balance between the protection and availability. So what is availability again? These terminologies come again and again. Please remember, you want to understand what are the terminologies I'm using every day. Availability, authentication, confidentiality, access control, non-reputation. So it should be considered between the balance between protection and availability. What are the resources available in the organization? What is the protection controls they are using to protect the information? All this comes under the security balance between the protection and availability. Information security must be managed similarly to manage any major system implemented in the organization using methodology called as a secure SDLC. We have discussed some security SDLC, system development life cycles. Analysis phase, investigation phase, design, logical design, physical design, maintenance. So every organization should maintain to implement and implement this methodologies here. Implementation of information security often described as a combination of art and science. Science means nothing but you need to have aware of the technologies here. Yes, we'll go to the second part of this chapter. This is the first chapter, first part of your chapter. The need of security. So the primary mission of information security is to ensure systems and contents stay the same. If no threats existed, resources could be focused on improving the systems. So what are the resources? There is no threat in the organization. Then what are the resources they are using for a particular organization can focus on improving the systems. So that resulting in vast improvements in ease of use and useful information. That means if there is no threats in your organization, you can go for the different types of controls. What are the resources you are using? What are the controls you are using to to protect your information systems. So we can focus on improving the systems and support information so that can result in the vast improvements. So in first phase, investigation provides overview of environment in which security most operate and other problems that security must address. Yes. So business needs first. So information security performs four important functions for the organization. One is protects organization's ability to function. Next one, enables safe operations of applications implemented on its IT systems. Protects data the organization collects and uses. And last one is safeguarding the organization technology assets. Okay, what are in use? We'll discuss each and everything clearly. Protecting the functionality of organization. So generally here, both general management and IT management are responsible for implementing implementation of information systems security that protects organization ability to function. So information security is a management issue in addition to the technical issue. It's a people's issue, you can say, in addition to the technical issue. So to assist management in addressing the needs for information security, we have some committees of interest must communicate in forms of business impact, you can say, and cost of business interruption, and also avoid agreements expressed only in the technical forms. Next one, enabling the safe operations of applications. Today, organizations under immense pressure to create and operate integrated, efficient, and capable applications. Modern organizations generally needs to create an environment that safeguards your applications using some organization's IT systems, you can say. Next one is protecting the data that organizations collect and use. So generally, organizations realize their most valuable assets is their data. Even for your organization also, the most valuable asset is your data. Students' data, faculty data, or maybe if you go for organization also, the faculty information, the organization's employees' information is the most valuable asset, you can say. So organization realize their most valuable asset is nothing but your data, your information. Because without data, any organization loses its record of transactions or its ability to deliver value to its customers. Yes or no? So we want to predict the data in the motion. Nothing but motion is nothing but in the transmit. When you are transmitting any information to the third parties or other organization people, you want to predict the data. You want to use some encryption techniques, some firewalls, some controls you need. Okay, predict the data in motion and data in rest. Data in rest is nothing but when you are storing the data in your computer or any particular hard disk. Putting data in motion and data in the rest, both are critical aspects of your information security. When you are transmitting the data or when you are storing the data, yes, you need to have some controls. You need to have some measures, countermeasures, some measures, some procedures, some policies to protect your data. An effective information security program is generally essential to protect protection of integrity and value of your organization data. Integrity, again, it is same the integrity. What is integrity? No addition, no deletion of your data, no adding extra information to your data. All this comes under the integrity. Next one, safeguarding. Safeguarding technology assets in the organization. Yes, organization is must add some secure infrastructure services based on its size and scope of the enterprise here. So if organization have more than 300 employees, if organization have more than 1,000 employees, okay, now then you need to provide the secure infrastructure services for your organization. Depends upon your size. What is the scope of your organization? So how many controls we need? How many safeguards we need? Security controls we need? Security systems we need to protect your data for your organization? Yes. So when organization grows and more capabilities are needed generally. So if your organization, if your example, you can take your college only, you have only 8 departments. Yes, if I increase more again, 10, if I have 8 departments, I increase 4 departments again, new departments. Then we need a different blocks, different departments, different blocks, different security measures, different benches. You're increasing the size of your organization. So when organization grows and more capabilities are needed here, so additional security services also needed, maybe provided for your organization for growth. So organization's network grows to accommodate changing needs. More robust technology solutions may be needed to replace the security programs to organization grow out. Yes or no? So these are the 4. Business need first, information security performs 4 important functions for the organization. One is protects ability to function, enable safe operation of applications in the systems, protects data the organization collects and uses, safeguards the technology assets in the use. Yes. Now we'll go for the threats. The time is 12:07. So we'll continue tomorrow class.